It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
51, come in. Over. 51, secure a breaker. Report, over.
The right.
Could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Surprise,
The famous writer Alan Wake just walked in. Folks, I'm gonna see if I can talk him into an interview.
Come on in, Mr. Wake. Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him.
Judas Priest!
What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
I had fallen off so many cliffs it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. Nightingale stared through the broken studio window into the dark woods. He turned around, started to walk out, but Maine grabbed his arm. Young man, you almost shot me. You don't shoot off rounds at people like that. What's the matter with you? Nightingale shook his arm free, marched out, his cheeks burned with rage and humiliation. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine. I had fallen off so many cliffs it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine. There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Thank you.
Sarah trusted her gut, and her gut said Agent Nightingale was an asshole. He felt wrong, and it wasn't just the smell of stale booze. It was in the way he flashed his badge, pulled rank, the look in his eyes when he wanted answers. Where was Alan Wake? What was this about an accident? Where was his wife? And most importantly, why did she let Wake go? He wouldn't answer her questions. Federal business was all he'd say.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. It's something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow. The pipe wrenched itself loose from the bridge's steel framework. Wrapped in darkness, it floated in midair, twitching. For a moment, I didn't understand what I was looking at. The heavy object lurched at me with impossible force. I threw myself out of the way, but just barely. When I turned my flashlight on it, it shook in a dark rage before it flew at me again. Oh. But she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. Sure. I hoped I could find a car from there. Pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. I hoped I could find a car from there. Pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. hoped I could find a car from there. Everything in its path. I hoped I could find a car from there. That was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer. The darkness surged towards me, sucking everything loose from the ground into its depths, tugging at my clothes. I saw the flare the kidnapper had dropped and threw myself towards it just as I felt my feet leave the ground. The darkness embraced me with the force of a tornado. Somehow I managed to light the flare. The darkness roared and cast me away. I fell toward the dark waters of the lake far below.
Thank you.
I had never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity. Thank you.